I thought I would say a few words about the first set here. It's brand new. It's from this summer. It's a setting of Robert Burns' poetry. I've loved Robert Burns' poetry for many years, a Scottish poet from the 1700s. But I always found his poetry to be so musical, but what I didn't realize at first was that they're actually songs. They're folk songs from Scotland. So the songs you're going to hear, 5 out of the 7 are actually folk tunes from Scotland. I wrote 2 of the tunes, but the rest are Scottish folk tunes that I arranged and set for piano. The first one, it's in a Scottish dialect, so it may be a little bit difficult, but just to get you thinking along the lines of the poems. Landlady count the law, and law is the bill. He's been in a bar basically all night long. He is drunk as a skunk, and the day is dawning, and he's starting to be more and more incoherent. He sings to his glass, and in the end, he sort of passes out. Galloway Tam is a rogue who sort of breezes into town and takes over this family. He has a thing with the man's daughter. It's the man who's singing, the father who's singing, has a thing with his daughter. He struck the man, kissed his wife, and then left. But it's a cheerful song. I think the father sees himself in the young man. He's a rogue, but he's a very charming, appealing rogue. The Ballad of John Barleycorn is a very imaginative text having to do with making whiskey from corn. Barleycorn is a personification of corn. And the whiskey makers are 3 kings. And they basically have this drama where it says they bury John Barleycorn, and they're planting him, and he rises up from the dead. That means he's growing, and then fall comes and he wilts, and then they hack him at the knees. That's when they're harvesting, and they thrash him and boil him in boiling water, and it all sounds so violent. It's just making whiskey. And eventually things get very rowdy, and it's sort of a toast to Scottish whiskey. Anna is a beautiful love poem. It's fair to say Burns loved being in love. Anna was one of a series of women that he just adored. And this is a beautiful poem about a secret meeting with her among the, probably a cornfield where nobody was around, and it was just all good as long as he was with her. I love that. I have a wife of my own, is when he first got married and he was feeling it. He was really feeling independent for the first time. A Wert Thou in the Cauld Blast is the last poem Robert Burns ever wrote. And there was a young woman caring for him, and she was lovely and wonderful, and he adored her. And he wrote the sweetest, loveliest poem to her. The Ploughman is really basically him. He grew up not in privilege. He grew up as a farmer, as a ploughman. And it's just kind of what the life of a ploughman is like. It's beautiful with nature and the fresh morning air. And it's lovely and wonderful. And it is my greatest pleasure of all to perform with such a wonderful singer. So let's do it.
So I get to take a moment to remind you that cell phones are a no-no.
Please turn them off.
No buzzing, no beeping, please. It actually affects the recording devices. does help us in the long run. Thank you very much.
Landlady, count alone in the days near the dawning. You're up like the runt, boys, and I'm but jolly. Galloway Tam came here to woo. I'd rather we give him the brownie coo. For all us best may curse and ban the wanton wit of Galloway Tam. Oh, Galloway Tam came here to shear. I'd rather we give him the good grey mare. He kissed the good wife and struck the good man, and that's the wit of Galloway. John Barleycorn should die. They took a plough and ploughed him down, put clod upon his head. And they have sworn a solemn oath John Barleycorn was dead. They have sworn a solemn oath that he was dead. Cheerful spring came kindly on, and showers began to fall. John Barleycorn got up again, and so surprised them all. The sultry suns of summer came, and he grew thick and strong. His head went armed with pointed spears that no one should him wrong. Armed with pointed spears that no one should him wrong. When he grew wan and pale, his bending joints and drooping head, so he began to fail. His color sickened more and more, he faded into rage. And then his enemies began to show their deadly rage. long and sharp and cut him by the knee. Then tied him up upon his back like a rope for watery. They laid him down upon his back and cuddled him full sore. They hung him up before the storm and turned him o'er and o'er. They hung him up and turned him o'er and o'er. Barleycorn, they let him sink or swim. They laid him out upon the floor to work in further war. And still as signs of life appeared, they tossed him to and fro. As life appeared, they tossed him to and fro. They wasted over a scorching flame the marrow of his bones. But a mill used him worst of all, for he crushed him between two stones. And they have taken his very heart's blood and drank it round and round. And still the more and more they drink, their joy did more abound. The more they drink, their joy did more abound. Of noble enterprise. For if you do but taste his blood, to make your courage rise, will make a man forget his woe, to heighten all his joy. Will make the widow's heart to sing, though the tear were in her eye. The heart to sing, though the tear were in her Barleycorn, each man a glass in hand. Then let us toast John Barleycorn, ne'er failing whole Scotland. And may his great prosperity ne'er fail in all Scotland. And may his great prosperity ne'er fail. Savannah, give me within my soul. imperial tongues, an empress or sultana, were dying raptures in I have a wife of my ain, I'll partake with nobody. I'll take cuckold from nain, I'll get cuckold from nobody. I have a penny to spend, there thanks to nobody. I have nothing to lend, I'll borrow from nobody. I am nobody's lord, I'll be slave to nobody. I have a good great sword, I'll take dunce from nobody. I'll be merry and free, I'll be sad for nobody. Nobody cares for me, I'll care for nobody.
Oh,
wildest waste, say black and bare, say black and bare. The desert were paradise if thou wert there. Or were I monarch of the globe, with thee to reign, with thee to reign, the brightest jewel in my crown would be my
like the